Class of 2023, please present yourself.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your caps for the singing and playing of the national anthem. Seated. Good evening, everyone. My name is Eliza Vanney, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to Huron High School's 55th commencement ceremony honoring the class of 2023. We have overcome some real challenges, like doing classes online for a year and a quarter thanks to COVID. Yet, I am happy to say that we came back strong and help build a culture of kindness, creativity, and leadership in this school. While I don't know every single graduate here personally, I can say for sure, everyone has worked incredibly hard to reach this point in their high school career, and that is something to be extremely proud of. I hope we all soak in this moment fully and appreciate it, as well as acknowledge all that our friends and family members have done to support us along the way. Thank you and congratulations, Rats! And now it's my pleasure to introduce Huron High School's principal, Che Carter.
Thank you and good evening. On the entire behalf of the entire faculty at Huron High School, welcome to the 2023 50th commencement. Clap. There you go. This graduation honors 4 years of high school education, a special occasion unique for each class. The culmination of years of hard work, the actualization of goals attained, and the acknowledgement of successes and achievements. It is a privilege to serve this community, and I'm honored and humbled to be a River Rat today. Thank you for having me. Before we get into the good part, I'd like to honor some of our distinguished guests. So please hold your applause while we call the names and they all can be recognized simultaneously. From our Board of Education, we have Ms. Jacinda Townsend, Guidance, President, Dr. Rima Muhammad, Vice President, Ms. Susan Basquette, Secretary, Ms. Crystal Dupree, Parliamentarian. From our executive leadership team, we have Dr. Janice Kerr-Swift, Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Dawn Linden, Assistant Superintendent, Teaching and Learning, Ms. Jill Minnick, Assistant Superintendent, Finance and Operations, Ms. Jazz Parks, Assistant Superintendent, School Leadership, Mr. John Randall, Assistant Superintendent, Human Resources and Employee Relations, Robin Thompson, Executive Director, High School Education, Dr. Roberta Hayward, Executive Director of Middle Level and K-8 Education, Mr. Matt Hilton, Executive Director for Elementary Education, Dr. Mary Ann Fedition, Executive Director, Office of Special Education, and Mr. Kevin Carr, Executive Director, Teaching and Learning, Ms. Liz Nolan Margolis, Executive Director of School Safety and District Operations. Can we all give them a round of applause for being here? I appreciate all the work that you do to help us do our jobs in the public schools. Huron High School has always been a special place where parents, teachers, staff, and community care for each other and build positive relationships that support academic and social-emotional growth. None of this happens without a strong team. So again, I thank the Board of Education and our district leadership for their support, but I'm humbled to stand alongside of Mr. Marcus Edmondson, Michael Summerton, Tony Wyron, Karen Siegel, and Tracy Stevenson on this leadership journey that we've undertaken. We have the privilege of being supported by high-quality staff of professionals, community members, and parents. Today, One River Rat faculty will be retiring at the end of the school year. So join me in acknowledging Mrs. Lauren Warren, librarian teacher, who has served as an educator for 31 years, but 23 years of those have been at Huron High School. And as we give her a round of applause, I ask that all Huron faculty stand to be recognized, please. Mrs. Warren, please stand so you can be recognized. Thank you. Thank you for spending countless hours providing rich learning opportunities and life lessons to all of our students, and thank you for being a shining light and inspiring young people to be the best versions of themselves. Teachers do possess the power to evoke change. Parents, families, and caregivers, we are inspired by your commitment to our youth and to public education. Horace Mann during the 19th century famously called education the great equalizer. Today, that remains true. Post-pandemic education should not look like it looked before the pandemic. American public education will be the remedy by which inequality of opportunity and access is reduced and eliminated. You can count on the Huron staff and the Ann Arbor Public Schools that we will respond to the challenge of redesigning the future of public education because we know all opportunities flow from a great education. Would you agree? So as I look out into this sea of green, it looks so beautiful, I gotta tell you. Would you agree? All right. Class of 2023, moving from this chapter, I encourage you to aggressively develop your human capital and do all you can to make certain that you are marketable in this capitalistic, ever-changing world. Most importantly, though, elevate humanity while doing so. You, me, and all the people on this stage have faced some adversity over the last 4 years. Trials and tribulations. These experiences are what binds us and makes us forever connected. We soldiered out together, we came through stronger. Helen Keller reminds us that character cannot be developed in ease and quiet. Only through experience of trial and suffering can the soul be strengthened. So expect adversity on your journey. And when you reflect back, notice those times of strife and struggle, and that in those times, no matter how much it hurt, the sole purpose was to strengthen you. Let those challenges strengthen you in ways to make you a wiser, more compassionate person. Move through your mistakes with gratitude. It's within those crises that your character will reveal who you really are. Missteps are part of this process, setbacks are setups, and we are all a work in progress. Today, I'm proud to say that 369 students have completed the requirements to graduate River Rat Strong. Round of applause. I, too, am a River Rat alumni, and earlier this week, we challenged all of our students to wear their bracelet. They all have these green and gold bracelets, and on them, they say hashtag thrive. We wholeheartedly believe that the experience at Huron, starting in ninth grade, prepares students to exit high school and be ready to thrive. There might be a few River Rats in this room. In fact, we're all over the world. I've shared that with a couple students. Being a River Rat, excellence is the expectation. But to show excellence means that one possesses qualities to a high degree, which means it's attainable for all of us. Your confidence will develop as a result of your intention to pursue excellence, not necessarily all the great moments. Your current state does not represent your future state. Do your best to make your actions align with your intentions. The rest will take care of itself. Stay self-aware as you go on to this journey. Some of you are super confident about the next steps, and others may feel a little overwhelming anticipation about what's next. Embrace it all, because you are wired for survival. You play for Huron. It's harder over here. Our standards are not something we whine about. They are something that we celebrate. That's a reminder from John U. Bacon, a former coach and author. You have this inner voice that only you will understand. That's what makes you special, unique, and absolutely necessary. Seek to understand what motivates you. It'll be you who determines the degree to which the higher self is achieved through all of your endeavors. Remember, in ninth grade, you were an adventurer. 10th grader, you were an explorer. 11th grade, you made some decisions. By your senior year, you became leaders. And now it's your time to thrive. Can we give them all a round of applause, please? On this journey that you are undertaking, be cautious to whom you share your hopes and dreams with. Only you can be you, and only you know what kind of person you want to be. Never stop learning. You acquire skill through repetition and practice over time. Excellence is not a fixed position. To show excellent means that one possesses qualities to a high degree. What you do most is what you'll do best. It doesn't matter how much you have or how far you go if you don't know how to treat people. I've worked really hard to model care, love, empathy, accountability, and respect. Your social capital is equal to or greater than your coin. So be intentional about how you treat people, because all people are living this human experience are deserving of respect and kindness. Be inclusive. Being inclusive is not as complicated as the world may make you seem. Okay? Listen. This is all you have to do to be inclusive. It's very simple. Listen, leave space for the needs of others, and center their voices and not your own when the decision is about their needs. This is what it means to move in care, love, empathy, accountability, and respect. If you can't remember that, just remember CLEAR, C-L-E-A-R. Care, love, empathy, accountability, respect. And by all means, resist instant gratification. Instant gratification has the potential to alter your reality. Most people go to work every day. Would you agree, parents, families out there? Most people go to work every day, right? People work hard for what they have, but they work even harder, and they have to stay disciplined to maintain what they have. So again, I urge you, resist instant gratification. When something comes easy to you, usually you let it go the same way. Don't be afraid to do the hard stuff. Every decision matters. Use your past experiences to your advantage. Act like the person you want to be until you figure out who you are. Do it at your pace, finish strong, stay focused on your goals, and don't worry about how long it takes. Embrace the journey, earn your leisure, leverage the people around you to reach your highest self. Ending an experience is the beginning of a new experience. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. reminds us all life is interrelated. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. So class of 2023, we have high hopes for you. We look forward to hearing from you in the coming years, whether you do it with courage or you do it scared. Always strive to do your best, stay steadfast in your pursuit of excellence, and just do the next right thing. Congratulations, class of 2023. You're going to hear a lot from Mr. Carter tonight, but we're going to keep this moving, and I would like to bring a music selection, America the Beautiful, by our Bel Canto a cappella choir and symphony orchestra, followed by our class message by Ms. Royce Smith. delivering our class message today, coming to the stage, Ms. Royce Smith.
Wow. It's hard to believe this day has finally come. It seems our bibs and diapers have been replaced so soon with caps and gowns. It's an honor to stand before you, yet bittersweet with only a few minutes to encompass these past 18 years of life. This time is precious, therefore I will aim for short and sweet. On that note, let's start with the very first day of kindergarten. Set aside sticky fingers in recess. That day is strikingly similar to the near future ahead of us. We will meet new people, relationships that are sure to teach us lessons on compassion, humility, pride, and acceptance. We'll explore our interests through trial and error, discovering the subjects that resonate the deepest in our souls and others that we'll avoid at all costs. We will fill our brains with easily forgotten formulas and a hefty list of acronyms, leaving the most room for jokes and stories to laugh about with friends. We will struggle to find where we fit in and to adhere to different rules or customs. But most importantly, we will end each day one step further along our individual journeys. We are the horizon that stretches endlessly, limitless possibilities beckoning in every direction. I've never seen such an intelligent, multi-talented, and driven group of people in my life, and I'm grateful to be part of such a diverse collection of peers. The world is starved of the change and innovation that this graduating class is beyond capable of. You don't need to be the most decorated athlete, the highest achiever, the recipient of Award X, or the president of Club Y to make an impact and succeed in life. It's not about being the best at what you do, but confronting each challenge to the best of your ability. It's vital to recognize that your potential has barely been skimmed and that each one of you has the capacity to do amazing things in your adulthood. Whether it be work, travel, further education, or any other path, as a Huron graduate, you've been equipped with the toolbox of unimaginable qualities. The ability to pull an all-nighter and get an A on that test? Check. The technique of shedding all shame while representing the one and only River Rat at competitions? Of course. The multitasking brilliance of eating lunch while maintaining multiple conversations all within a 26-minute lunch period? Affirmative. Class of 2023, we have it all. More seriously, at our fingertips is everything and anything we've ever learned. Millions of buds waiting to blossom under the freshness of new beginnings. We were just freshmen with 4 looming years of school stretched before us. Can you believe we made it? Be proud of your academic work and the hours you spent studying. Be proud of the moments you fell behind, but picked yourself back up. Be proud of the efforts you put into starting new clubs or continuing the legacy of others. Be proud of the auditions you painstakingly prepared for and the concerts where you shone. Be proud of grinding through practices and celebrating victories in stadiums throughout the state. Be proud that by embodying the spirit of a River Rat, you'll be walking on this stage shortly for recognition of all you've accomplished on your own. But it's important to recognize the foundation of support we've had the luck of building so beautifully upon. Our parents, guardians, family, and friends deserve an encore to the celebration of achievement. They've made incredible sacrifices to nurture our growth and should receive their own diploma for their perseverance and unconditional love. Another group of people that deserves the world and beyond is the staff at Huron High School. An encouraging staff has made it possible for this community to continue to thrive and flourish despite the many setbacks of these past 4 years. Teachers, you all especially have been the catalyzers of our cultivation. Without your motivation and care that was placed upon each student in the content taught, great public education wouldn't be possible. We thank you and hope your value continues to be recognized. Let me tell you a secret. I'm often absolutely terrified of the future. I'm scared that everything will go wrong and I'll be lost navigating the world on my own. As I stand here now, I realize how foolish it is to let fear hold you back. What would come of the world if everyone was too scared to try something new? In this next chapter of your life, take those risks, push those boundaries, fight for what you think is right, especially when you're silenced in society. Fear of failure is the greatest barrier to success, and life is too short to believe that failure is anything but a crucial learning experience. Today is your celebration. Congratulations, class of 2023. Make it a great day, a great year, a great life. As Mr. Carter adamantly reminds us, The choice is yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Smith. We will now have a music selection, A Thousand Years. Thank you. Keep it going, please. One more round of applause. That was beautiful, beautiful. We are now going to present our class gifts. Coming up to the podium are Liliana Barrientes and Jasmine Harris. The Board of Education President will receive the gift.
Thank you, Board of Trustees and President Jacinda Townsend-Guides. I am Liliana Barrientes.
And I am Jasmine Harris, and we are members of the Senior Class Executive Board. On behalf of the Class of 2023, the Senior Executive Board would like to gift the incoming Huron Class of 2027 $1,000 as they begin to prepare school-wide events and volunteer opportunities that represent, support, and celebrate our global community.
Additionally, the senior class acknowledges and understands the value in sharing and reporting on real-world issues and is gifting $500 to the nationally award-winning student publication, the Huron Emory Newspaper, so that they may continue to inform our Huron community for years and years to come.
Thank you so much to Jasmine and Liliana, and thank you to the senior class for such a generous gift. So River Rats of 23, you guys are so special to me that I've been crying since 4 o'clock. It's in part because my favorite hero sits among you, and I won't embarrass her, Rihanna Guidus. but I just want to say, you know, to all you parents, I feel like one of my highest purposes tonight is to tell you it's okay to cry, families. To River Rats, I want to tell you this. An educator, Neil Postman, once said, "Children are a message that we send to a time we will not see." And I want to tell you that all of your family, all of your friends who are here, all of your teachers who are here, all of these administrators and staff who cared for you, we all know that you're your own message. And we all know that you guys are going to go out there and crush it. And you are going to make this world a better place, as you just did with this generous gift. So I just want to tell you that while you're doing that, all of us back here in Ann Arbor are going to be terribly proud of you. Thank you.
You will now hear the Huron alma mater, "On the Banks of the Huron," by the Bel Canto A Cappella Choir Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Ahmed Hajazi.
Thank you.
While our students are moving back to their seat, I want to know a room check. How many River Rat graduates are in the room? Make some noise. Worldwide. One more time. All the River Rats in the house, make some noise. So my class of 2023, as they're going back to their seats, you heard the roar in this room. Someone made the decision to send you to the high school that they went to in hopes that you would have a similar experience or even a better experience than they had. I will say this again, we are worldwide. So thank you and thank you again. As we prepare to honor our students, the citizenship and scholarship honors for our senior class, we're going to recognize several students who have received citizenship awards, and we are going to recognize approximately 91 students who've maintained over their career at Huron High School a 3.9 or above grade point average. I was not a 3.9 student, but I knew plenty. And again, Huron High School is getting ready to be on display. When we call the students up, again, those students with a 3.9 above career GPA, please come forward. As they're coming to the stage, I also want to remind you that we have one presidential scholar candidate semifinalist. We have 15 national merit semifinalists, 14 finalists, and the total number of students with honors diplomas are 138. Round of applause. Each of these students will receive a token of appreciation by our amazing assistant principals. And please clap for all students. And if you're not on this stage, what we know about students and what we know about education now, that is an excellent achievement. But everyone at Huron High School finds their niche, they find their thing. So can we give it up for all of our students, because we've all accomplished something at Huron High School. Thumbs up, admin team. They all have them now? All right, round of applause. Let's go. Huron High School gives special recognition to seniors who are designated by the faculty and staff to be outstanding scholars and citizens. The following awards will be given out today, as you can see in your program. As students go back to their seat, these students do not know their names are going to be called, but I did urge them to walk with a purpose when their name is called. 91. As Dr. Swift would say, it's all of your fault, all of yours. So congratulations to the families and to our educators as well. Congratulations. That's your saying. The Paul K. Myers Award is named for the first principal of Huron High School. This is a recognition of good scholarship, clean personal character, leadership of fellow students, dependability in worthy enterprises, and service to the school in athletics, public speaking, dramatics, music, art, publications, and student government. Our recipients this year, Jagan Song and Catherine Lee, come forward. Catherine B. Lee, thank you. Congratulations. Our next award, congratulations. The next award is the University of Michigan Citizenship Award, and that goes to Zachary Geyer and Lauren Dubin. Come on up. This is a recognition of good scholarship, clean personal character, leadership of fellow students, and dependability in worthy enterprises and service to the school in athletics, public speaking, dramatics, music, art publications, and student government. Congratulations. Our next award is for the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Award, and the recipients are Jamil Thomas and Sarayan Kaba. Come on up. This honors special recognition to those who made outstanding contributions in the fields of civil rights. The intent of this award is to honor students who have personal relations that reflect respect, consideration for others regardless of their race or status, and they display leadership in promoting respect and consideration. They have been engaged in organizing efforts to Huron to improve human relations. Congratulations. Our next award is our beloved former principal and my principal, and maybe some of yours when we attended Huron High School, the Dr. Joetta Mile Understanding and Sharing Diversity Award goes to Naloy Jamil and Kamara Orr. Come on up. This award is for students who've made outstanding contributions to understanding and sharing, appreciating the cultural diversity of Huron. The intent of this award is to honor those students who demonstrate the following characteristics: a knowledge and understanding of cultural, ethnic, racial, and religious differences, and appreciations of the contributions, styles, and values of others. Dr. Mile talked to me on her birthday, on her 92nd birthday, and I shared the news that we would make sure that her name was heard forevermore at Huron High School. So again, congratulations to all of you. The next award is the Charles Baird Humanitarian Award. That goes to Gael Borges and Lucy Schwindewind. This award is not intended to be given for popularity or academic achievement or leadership or extensive participation. It's intended for humanitarian service towards others using the follow basic guidelines: humanitarian attitude towards classmates, high moral character, and outstanding dependability and an unselfish outlook. Congratulations. Our final annual award is named after our former principal, one of our former principals, Dr. Arthur L. Williams. It's called the Integrity Award, and that goes to four students: Noah Takins, Armand Kamat, Simone Wallace, Brianna Mayers. Come on up. This award, given to those who've made outstanding contributions to Huron High School, the intent of the award is to honor those students who've made positive contributions to the Huron climate and display the characteristics of friendship, understanding, and optimism. Congratulations. Our amazing faculty nominated all of these students. That was the process involved. As our students are headed back, I would like to bring to the stage one of our phenomenal teachers, Mrs. Chris Zager, an English language arts teacher. She was selected by the class of 2023 to give the commencement address. So I welcome to the stage Ms. Chris Zager.
Good afternoon, graduates and guests. This class has truly impacted me more than any group of students I've known, so I felt incredibly honored when I was asked to speak. But I was also alarmed because when I think of a commencement address, I think of inspirational cliches and motivational speakers, and I feared that there was too thick a coating of cynicism on my millennial heart for me to deliver that kind of speech. But Huron High School class of 2023, you are the best, and you deserve my best effort. So I decided to lean in and indulge in one of the cringiest cliches that I have read recently. And this is by Vivian Green, who, very much unlike me, is a motivational speaker figures. Life is not about waiting for the storm to pass. It is about learning to dance in the rain. Oh, some of you cringed already, huh? Dancing in the rain, that is prime fridge magnet wisdom right there. But David Foster Wallace once said that in the day-to-day trenches of adult existence, banal platitudes have a life or death importance. And I think that Miss Green's cheesy injunction to dance in the metaphorical rain is actually vital for adult life. Class of 2023, you've already waited out several storms, most recently college admissions, job applications, exams. Exams are classic powering through material, right? Nobody is dancing in the rain of exams. You just get through. Your high school years also included a unique storm. In your very first year as River Rats, I personally said goodbye one by one to 93 of you on a surreal Friday afternoon as we were thrust into quarantine. And society could not dance in this level of rain. We supported each other, found light, but it was hard. We lost people. Some of you worried about family members working in hospitals, risking their health for others. Some of you cared for your younger siblings while trying to navigate online school. Many of you struggled emotionally or academically or maybe both, but you made it through, and I am so proud of you for that. And COVID was a big storm, a shelter in place and secure the furniture type of storm, and life unfortunately has other storms like that. The loss of an important job, a physical or mental health crisis, the death of a loved one. Weathering these kinds of storms is a life-saving mode we activate at key moments. But like many coping skills, when we get too good at it, when we activate it in non-crisis times, it can become a crutch. We get stuck in that mode, and we do so at the expense of being awake and aware and engaged in our own lives. Because, River Rats, it's always raining somewhere. When your personal life is going great, there's a crisis at work, and vice versa. And if nothing else, there are bills to pay, laundry, projects, 1,000 little weather events to wait out. Perhaps the most constant storm of all is the inescapable awareness of our own imperfection. We don't feel smart or strong or attractive enough, and that can become a reason not to live fully. Instead of asking a question in class, you assume your confusion is your fault, or you're invited to a party. But a familiar dread of not fitting in quickly replaces initial excitement. Or you want to tell your crush how you feel. but instead you hide from the rain of your self-imposed inadequacy. Or maybe you're being mistreated by somebody close to you, but you think, I'm just gonna get through this, I'm gonna deal with it, and one day, I will figure out just the perfect way to finally stand up for myself. Or maybe, river rats, you see an injustice, a discriminatory system that others prop up, but you think, what can I do? I'm not gonna stay here forever. I'll just wait for this storm to pass. And as you wait out the various storms, you imagine a utopian future with no pressing responsibilities, nobody sick, nobody in trouble, no balls in the air, sunny weather all across the globe. And in this mythical utopia, you will finally write that book, speak up, repair that broken relationship, find your true passion. But as all the adults in the room can attest, at least on this imperfect earth, such a perfect lull will never come. Instead, you just wait out a series of storms that ebb and flow but never abate, wasting your sometimes boring, sometimes crazy, drizzly, cloudy, wonderful, actual life while waiting for your clear-skied, mythical life to begin. And this is not to say that we should settle. We can and should become better versions of ourselves, absolutely. But we can do that while other people watch. We don't have to do it in some, you know, closet of shame. If anyone's keeping track, by the way, closet of shame is my 12th metaphor, so just if you were keeping count. But it's not always graceful self-improvement. You know, in the movies, self-improvement is always this big reveal. The silent bullied kid has their Oscar-winning moment in homeroom, or the bashful suitor eloquently declares their love on the runway. The beleaguered employee finally says all that stuff they've been wanting to say for years and flounces out, dignity intact. But that's not real. When you try to change, for example, when you try to reveal a hidden part of your identity, that's really scary. And you might sound inarticulate instead of eloquent. Or when you try to be on time, eat healthier, or practice gratitude, whatever you're working on, you will regress. It doesn't happen all at once, and it's not always pretty. But the key is to let other people in, to let other people see. And so, river rats, go outside, okay? Maybe you're not ready to dance in the rain yet, but go outside. All these beautiful high school friends you have, FaceTime them even when you have projects due at college. Go to your family's dinner even when your car needs to be fixed and your client keeps emailing you outside of work hours. Tell your crush you like them now, because you know what? Now is when you like them. Perfect you might not even like them. Carve out time to play sports, write, draw, make music, whatever it is that makes you feel alive. Whatever you imagine doing in that mythical future utopia, don't wait for clear skies. Do it while it rains. Huron High School class of 2023, we're so proud of you. We love you and we will miss you so much. We're still here if you need us. Congratulations.
At this time, for presentation of the class of 2023, I'd like to invite to the stage Dr. Janice K. Swift, Superintendent of Schools.
Well, how about Ms. Zager and Royce and Eliza? Give them a big hand. That was wonderful. Yay. Well, good evening. What an extraordinary evening in the Ann Arbor Public Schools as we gather together at this commencement ceremony to honor and celebrate you, Huron High School, class of 2023. And indeed, you are an impressive sight, River Rats. 369 strong, an expanse of green and gold, hailing from the Ann Arbor High School, situated along the banks of the Huron River. Home, really the one and only anywhere home of the River Rats. We are so proud of you tonight. It is such an honor to gather together this evening with your teachers, our support staff, our school leaders, alongside your parents, families, and friends in our greater Ann Arbor community. In the presence of the trustees of the Board of Education, we are gathered here to publicly honor and celebrate each of you as you achieve this milestone of high school graduation. Now, in celebrating each of you this evening, we see you, we hear your important voices, we honor your unique stories and the many challenges you have overcome to arrive in your place this evening. Here on class of 2023, other speakers have noted it. I want to add my part. You have shown remarkable strength and perseverance as you have traversed your high school career amid a time of a global pandemic and historic disruption. Rats, you did not allow the extraordinary challenges of this time to stop you from achieving your goal. We recognize and honor you, especially for the hurdles you have overcome to arrive at this commencement ceremony. And tonight you arrive at this achievement of high school graduation. I want to remind you that you emerge from a strong and powerful place, Huron High School. Tonight you join a long and distinguished tradition as Huron High School, Ann Arbor Public Schools alumni. That's a good word, graduates, alumni. You'll be there soon. I want to take just a moment to recognize all of the teachers, support staff, and building leaders. River Rats, not just those you're thinking of who are here with us this evening, but roll back in the video that you have up here back to preschool and kindergarten and all of those educators who have guided and supported you through from your earliest days of preschool, kindergarten. You began back around 2010. And they've been with you through all your years of elementary, middle, and high school. We also offer our deep gratitude to the Huron staff, our teachers, support staff, and administrators for all they have done over these 4 years to support and guide our students through these critical years of high school. Please join me in a round of applause for this Huron High School team. Parents of the class of 2023, from our hearts, thank you for raising such amazing individuals. Thank you for all you've done to support and guide them. They have persevered and achieved in spite of the obstacles they face because of you, your commitment, your love, and your guidance. Thank you for sharing these beautiful young people with us at Huron High School and in the Ann Arbor Public Schools. Thank you, parents. Surely it takes a village. Now, Huron River Rats, I want to speak with you for just a moment. Now, I am mindful that at this point, I'm the only thing standing between you and the diploma. So let's focus in. Here we go. I want you to know that every experience you've had on your journey has prepared you for this very moment. And tonight, you have absolutely everything it takes to move forward with confidence and impact our world in profound and positive ways. You have persevered and overcome. You represent a unique and special generation. History has called you to this moment. This is your moment. Class of 2023. Now tonight I'm hoping to share with you an excerpt from a poem by Amanda Gorman. You may recognize this. She was the National Youth Poet Laureate. Her poem is called "The Hill We Climb." Amanda holds the distinction of serving as the youngest inaugural poet in U.S. history. And she read this poem at the 2021 presidential inauguration. May Amanda Gorman's beautiful message serve as a blessing that we share together as a community with you graduates this evening. She says it like this: in this truth, in this faith, we trust. For while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption. We feared it at its inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour. But within it, we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So while once we asked, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe? Now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but we will move to what shall be, a country that is bruised but whole, benevolent but bold, fierce and free. We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens, but one thing is certain. If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left. With every breath from our bronze-pounded chest, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise, we will rebuild, reconcile, and recover. In every known nook of our nation and every corner called our country, our people, diverse and dutiful, will emerge battered but beautiful. When the day comes, we step out of the shade aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it. Huron class of 2023, you are brave. You are beautiful. We are in awe of your brilliant light. Go, let your light shine. And it is at this time, Principal Carter, on behalf of the Ann Arbor Public Schools Board of Education, I formally accept the Huron High School class of 2023. As having fulfilled all of the requirements and obligations necessary for graduation from the Ann Arbor Public Schools, as Superintendent of Schools, I hereby authorize the awarding of the diplomas. Congratulations and best wishes, class of 2023.
As we're getting set up for our diplomas and people start to take their spaces, this is the last time you'll hear Mr. Carter speaking. I want to thank you again, class of 2023, for putting your trust in me. I want to thank all the families in the community for putting your trust in me. And I look forward to taking lots of pictures when this is all said and done. I'm going to take my place. Thank you again. Love you guys. Appreciate it.
Minna Abdel Kalik. Tiawani Edwesan. Amr El Ebedi. Nadine El Maya. Aaron Al Rahim. Justin Alcala. Anna Alexandrov. Rand Alsaman. Ashley Andriga. Avery Angeli. Sumaya Archer. Geraldine Arias Salazar. Suhai Bawad. Kemi Bailey. Timothy Baker. Casey Baldridge. Alex Ball. Candace Barnes. Liliana Barrientes. Timothy Bass. Alfredo Bautista Reyes. Aiden Beamer. Yeah, I know. TJ Bell. Ricardo Bibbins. Adam Bigelow. Layla Blair. Gael Borges. Grant Borgman. Josiah Borkins. Janiah Boyd. Braxton Brand. Daniel Brecken. Cameron Brown. Brennan Brooke. Hannah Berman. Dora Alicia Callejas Gomez. Yingtao Cao. Rebecca Carlson. Harmony Cartwright. Rosa Casarella. Sebastian Casillas Lopez. Carlos Castrion. Cindy Chen. Melania Cherapanina. Connor Chittick. Ava Chinnacro. Nathan Choi. Rafay Chowdhury. Logan Cole. Shanae Coleman. Dior Conde. Marissa Potitsis. Tamia Crawford. Julianne Kukos. Abigail Cullen. Ruben Dabagian. Andre DaCosta. Ajay Das. Aaliyah Davis. Idalis Davis. Haley Delp. Alexandra Denneke. Aaliyah Diara. Braylon Dickerson. Andrew Dimcheff. Elliot Dimcheff. Jordan Douglas. Henry Dusemi. Priscilla Dew. Lauren Dubin. Raquisha Dukes. Zaria Dumas. Amari Eddins. Sean Edelman. Trey Edmondson. Caleb Edwards. Erkush Erdenabat. Mashad Evans. Yancheng Fang. Mariam Fasina. Emily Fazing. Sophia Fatchett. Peter Fazakush. Tarek Furman. Madeline Finnemore. Ohanzi Flores. Caitlin Fong. John Fowowi. Skylar Freck. Avier Fry. Sandra Fu. Joshua Galan. Lanaya Gandhi. Johanna Garcia Quejada. Brandon Garduño. Stephanie Garduño. Sahir Gatson. Zachary Geyer. Rihanna Guidus. Hannah Glover. Samantha Goldstein.
Dhruva Gobalakrishnan.
Aiden Gray. Donnell Green. Torrance Green. Brady Grenier. Chloe Griffiths. Caroline Gunther.
Maximilian Hare. Miles Hallam. Jordan Hang. Raylan Hang. Danielle Harris. Jasmine Harris. William Harris. Thomas Hart. Ayn Hadzi Rosman. Talia Haynes. Virginia He. Caitlin Heffernan. Annalisa Heisenbutel. Ahmed Hijazi. Rachel Henderson. Bianca Herman. Nayeli Hernandez Mendez. Maisie Hickling. Zachary Hildebrandt. Callie Heilman. Anastasia Hill. Christoph Hopp. Morgan Hargrove. Beatrice Singh. Davis Hugan. Arij Hussein. Miriam Icarbine. Ryan Ilgen. Izzy Adendi. Amaya Ingram. Noor Ismail. Drew Jackson. Braden James. Niloy Jamil. Gavin Jeffries. Kenneth Jiang. Nicholas Jiang. Samara Jihad. Kehan Jin. Adam Johnson. Kellen Johnson. Mosi Jones. Kevin Ju. Saran Kaba. Arman Kamat. Omukeri Kane. Varshini Kashyap. Christian Kasselnick. Javion Cater. Alexander Katsimburis. Thomas Keen. Samantha Ketzlack. Hiba Khan. Alex Kim. Ann Kim. Sarah Kim. Jonathan Kimberly. Xavier Kinch. Hoan Gina Cole. Ridima Kodali. Arvind Krishnan. Ava Kunith. Aditya Lasko. Khan Layson. Felix Lahan. Jaya Lawrence. Duyen Lee. Daniel Lee. Daniel Lee. Daniel H. Lee. Ted Lee. Sonia Liggett Prince. Henry Leto. Carissa Lerma. Joanna Lewandowska. Catherine B. Lee. Catherine X. Lee. Gangshin Lee. Charles Lincoln. Colin Lister. Benjamin Locke. Sean Logan. Ashley Lopez Salazar. Mary Tabita Lupus. Robert Lynn. Emily Ma. Raghav Bajitia. Amani Macau. Priyanka Malik. Sonora Manthi. Layla Marks. Ashley Martinez. Cody Martinez. Brianna Mayers. Kiara McBride. Aaron McGee. Davion McLilly. Chesedek McPhee. Abigail Megason. Allison Mee. Aiko Miao. Heidi Miao. Nyree Middlebrooks. Burhan Mohsen. Miguel Moncada Larrutis. Tamar Moore. Trinity Morgan. Alexander Moskis. Tess Moyer. Natalie Muntz. Samirin Mooley. Gino Murdoch. Jeanette Mushia. Ashna Narajana. Mariam Nasuna. Jasmine Nava. Habib Najad. Connor Newell. Quinn Newhouse. Jesse Newpole. I got it, Jason. I got it. Jason Nguyen. No problem. Ibrahim Niegadu. Leonardo Nicio. Aaliyah Nehemiah Burns. Nana Encansando. Ava Nolan. Alicia Norden. Joe O'Neill. Go ahead. Deborah Obi. Daniela Ojeda. Precious Oladipo. Ivan Olsen Munoz. Harley Orozco. Kamara Orr. Anna Ortega Rocha. Rachel Overgaard.
Hugo Pacheco Escrivo. Grace Pang. Lily Papp. Kelly Park. Kavion Parker. Maximus Parkin. Nicholas Paulkin. Cecilia Kirby Pedigo. Justin Pelton. Carrillo Paracleta. TJ Peterson. Zachary Phelps. Bianca Philpott. Anderson Piper Wagner. Sophia Piper. Jackson Pollard. Christine Pope.
Madison Powell.
Ananya Prasanna. Anna Prince.
You're doing good.
Jolie Pryor. Munis Qureshi. Armando Ramos. Juan Randall Jr. Deja Rankin. Martina Redding Sunyol. Amaya Reeves. Yeah.
Julia Rem. Jamal Richardson. Markel Robertson. Micah Robertson. Mackenzie Robinson. Tanya Daniela Rodriguez. Alex Romero Esquivel. Zaire's Ruff. Alex Sable.
Adam Samaha.
Devin Saxon. Natalie Scarlett. Oliver Schmid. Elliot Schnabel. Lucy Schneidewind. Peter Schneidewind. Schweideman. Lucas Scott. Laith Shama. Ryan Shelton. Erica Shumsky. Alexander Simino. Nathan Sinkowitz. Savion Sarathasik. Caden Slam. Royce Smith. Mia Solomon. Yep. Jagan Song. Jacob Spiels. Kendall Stacy. Abigail Steele. Shania Stewart. Lillian Stewart. Taeyong Sukin. Yahoon Sa. Saja Sukar. Mina Suresh. Tyler Sweet. Michael Tabaki. Noah Takens. Faven Teclamarium. Tessa Mikol Tesfamarium. Tamer Tamarov. James Thomas III. Jamari Thomas. Jamil Thomas. Sophia Toplin. Ibrahima Touri.
Ava Tunison. Shaylee Valenti Ketzner. Eliza Vanny. Shrikarthik Vangavulu. Anthony Varkey. Sophia Vasquez. Jose Vega. Braden Viver. Simone Wallace. Mia Wamstaker. Suha Walker. Walker. Hannah Watt. Christian Waugh. Lania Wells. Davian White. Jacob White. Bruce Williams. Connor Williams. Jonathan Williams. Kaya Williams. Cameron Williams. Kendall Williams. Marcus Williams. Shane Williams. Brooke Wilson. Gabriella Wilson. Catherine Winkler. Cameron Wright. Catherine Wright. Crystal Wu. Sophia Nguyen. Jerry Yang. Chingray Yang. Annabelle Yi. Christopher Yu. Nicholas Yu. Xavier Yule. Vinette Zurasanai. Kevin Zhang. Audrey Zhao. Eric Zhao. Kira Zhao. Kyla Zhao. Henry Zucker.
Stefan Zakowski.
Will the class of 2023 please rise? Please move your tassels from right to left. You are now a Huron alumni. Congratulations.
All right, you're all first.